Oh, good morning from Slingshot. It's a Merry Christmas, December the 25th, and just wanted to say hello to everybody. I hope everybody's having a really great Christmas. I'm having a great one, but I'm frustrated because right now it's 25 degrees and the wind is blowing, and with the wind chill, that's probably like 19 degrees, and I wanted to ride my bike. But what I'm going to do is, I got some new pedals, some clip-in pedals, and I'm going to put them on the bike, and maybe before this weekend is out, we're going to go ahead and maybe get a ride in. So I'm going to video and let you guys watch as I put my pedals on step by step, and then that way you can see what it takes, and if you're in the upgrade for pedals, you'll see that it's probably a simple process. So what I'm going to do is I will come back here in just a few minutes as we are putting the pedals on my bike. Right now you can see it's under the cover. Like I said, it's cold out here, man, and I really haven't ridden in about a week and a half, and want to get out there, but at the same time I want to be smart. It's really cold out here, and so we're going to go ahead and put these pedals on, and we'll be back in just a few minutes. Wow, wanted you guys to see, this is ice as I was taking the cover off my bike, just to let you know how cold it is here. This is actually the ice that is falling off of my my cover, okay? So, yeah, man, I wanted to ride, but right now it's just not cool. So I'll catch you guys inside as we put the pedals on. All right, as you can see, I have my bike mounted up on my mic stand. I got some Leandria Johnson playing in the background, just chilling. But the first little hiccup that we've come on is that if you look here behind my pedals, most of the pedals have the hexagon opening that you can put the wrench in. But as you can see, this particular bike, I'm going to have to use a wrench and get it from this side. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to take my bike off of the mount, put it on the ground so I can get a little bit of leverage so I can begin to take those pedals off. So I'll be back in just a few minutes as I get it off the stand, and we're gonna put it down on the ground, and we're gonna continue to put these pedals on. All right, I've got the bike off of the rack, and I have just a multi-wrench tool here. This actually came from, this is probably over 15, 20 years old. When I was a bicycle police officer, this is one of the tools that we had to use our mountain bikes. But I'm just gonna go ahead and see if I can get this off here. Looks like I'm probably gonna need to get something to give me a little bit of leverage here, so I am going to get a hammer. All right, I found the hammer, and we're gonna go ahead and try to get this pedal off. If you are trying to take the pedals off, the pedals turn the opposite way on each side, which means that on the crank side, if you're trying to get your pedal off, you'll turn it anti-clockwise. But since we're on the opposite side, we're going to turn the wrench clockwise to get the pedal off. So all I'm gonna do with this is just loosen it up a little bit with the hammer. Let's see here. Ooh, okay. And then just start turning it. Turning it up.
until it comes off. It's almost hand loosened now. And all we have to remember is when we're putting it back on, putting a new one on, that we're going to turn this side counterclockwise to tighten. All right, so as you can see, I have the pedal off. And, now these pedals that I have here they're multi-purpose pedals, which means that you can clip in if you have the clipless shoes, but then if you don't want to clip in, you can use the other side. For me, since I'm just starting now with these clip-on pedals, I'm just going to try the clipless. I'm going to try this multi-purpose here, and then eventually I'll upgrade. All right. Let's see. All right. I was looking for my reflectors. These pedals came with the reflector. These pedals came as a part of a Christmas gift set. My wife got me some shoes. They're the Venzo shoes, and these pedals, they're a combination. And to prove to you that cycling does not have to be super expensive, the set was only $100. And some of you cyclists know that there are way more expensive sets out there. But for me, you know, I just wanted to be able to get started. And like I said, again, to show you that it doesn't take a lot of money in order to have a good cycling experience. So all I'm doing right now is I'm just clipping these reflectors on here, and we have them put on. And so we're going to start the install of the pedal here. All right, and remember, to get this one on, we're going to go counterclockwise. And another good thing is this, the pedals have the left and the right already labeled on them. So I don't know if you can see this, and I hope you can. There's an L here for left. And so this is the actual left side of the bike. So we're going to put this on counterclockwise. All right, and I can start it by hand. Now, the good thing for these pedals is that they come with the Allen wrench fitting on the back. And I have just an Allen wrench tool here. I think I got this with my tool bag from Walmart. I ordered it from Walmart online, and it has the different Allen wrenches on the back, and I think this one takes a size 6. I'm just gonna remove my water bottle here so I can get to it a little bit better and see if that fits in there. And it does. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna go around on the other side of the bike so I can reach it a little bit better. All right. Okay, I'm on the other side of the bike here, and I'm just gonna use this Allen wrench, and again, turning it counterclockwise so I can get this tightened on here. And they sell long handle Allen wrenches. I just don't happen to have one, but this one will do the trick just fine. So I'm just gonna turn it. Close all these other wrenches to make my turning. And again, I just wanna show you this process in real time. So you can see that if I can do it, that you can do it as well. Some of you may be able to even do it with a little bit more ease. One of my challenges is that I'm not a super duper mechanical guy, but again, you don't have to be. Let's see if I can get this turned around here so I can. There we go. Now this should let me get to the pedal just a little bit better. And in the background, that was PJ Morton when we first began from the Gumbo album, I think. Turning it. Yep.
Peace, thank you.
Turn. Remember, counterclockwise. And you can put grease on your threads to make it a little bit easier. I didn't, but you can. And as tight as I want this, is I just want it a little bit beyond hand tight because the pedals are not going to come off. But as you can see, this one is already installed. And that pretty much was the whole process for this. So what I'm going to do now is I am going to install the other side. So in just one moment, I'll come back and then the bike will be turned around so you can see how I do the other side. And we'll be halfway through. All right, now we're on the other side. And remember, I told you that on the opposite saddle, which is the anti-crank side, the drill turned clockwise. And so this one is going to turn counterclockwise. So I've got the wrench on here, and we're gonna turn it counterclockwise. Counterclockwise here. Counter, yep. Yep. And just counterclockwise. And this one is a little bit looser. I'm gonna go ahead and get some lube and spray it in here a little bit just to make it easier. I'm probably gonna take the other one off and do that as well a little bit later on. Okay, we're back. I just have some regular WD-40 bike all conditioning lube. I got this from Ace Hardware. Okay, and all I'm gonna do is, on the threads here, take the straw and just spray a little bit in the threads. Well, I want to use a straw. Spray it in there. And then with the other pedal, what I've done is I just went on and clipped the reflectors on in there. And so now I'm just going to go ahead and start the threading of this one. Okay. I'm going to turn my crank. Okay, so I can kind of get to it a little bit better. I've turned the crank there, so I'm just gonna go ahead now. And remember that it was counterclockwise to loosen, so now all we're gonna do is just go clockwise to tighten, that's all. Not super hard. I'm just gonna take the tool here, finish tightening it. Background, that's B Slade, aka Tone, singing "I Know I've Been Changed." Just I listen to music a lot while I'm riding, but I also listen to music a lot when I'm just doing work on my bike or whatever. So I don't own the rights to the music. That is B. Slade, Tone A, singing. And we're tightening it up a little bit here. And again, I'm just gonna crank down it a little bit, hand tighten. There we go. And again, I'm gonna show you a cool feature on these pedals. As I said here, I can clip in with my clipless shoes, but again, if I don't wanna do that and I still wanna ride the bike, I can ride it here and there's not gonna be any issue with riding either way. So as I said, for me, I'm a beginner on the clip-in pedals, so I'm going to use these just to get me started. And then once I get a little bit more comfortable on it, I'm probably gonna always keep these pedals, but I'll probably just add a different pedal to my bike. All right, that's all that it takes to get the pedals onto your bike. All right, again, I just want to show you guys how easy it is to install your clipless pedals onto your bike. If I can do it, you can do it. Again, I'm going to put some links down in my into the comments there on where you can get the pedals. Also, I'm going to put a video later showing me putting my actual clips on my shoes. So again, hope you guys are enjoying this Christmas. Hope wherever you are, if you want to ride, you're able to get out and do so safely. Again, this is Stan Carpenter from Slingshot, hoping that you use my momentum to draft you and to propel you into great cycling health. So we'll be back on with another video in just a few minutes. Merry Christmas.